Hello YouTube, how is everyone doing? It's Professional here. So today I have the very first part of Grand Theft Auto Liberty City Stories. Now I will be playing through the PS2 version on this playthrough, and this is a game that has a pretty special place in my heart. I just absolutely love this game. And this game, I played this originally on the PSP. This game came out on the PSP, I think it was 2005 or 2006. It was around there, but it was one of the first games that I got on the PSP. It was an awesome game. And this is a very underrated GTA. Not a lot of people are actually familiar with Liberty City Stories. Liberty City Stories, this game takes place in 1998. So this is a prequel to GTA 3, actually. It takes place 3 years before that. It's the same map as GTA 3, but there's a few differences. They changed up a few different things. Obviously, has a little bit better graphics also. And you're playing actually as Toni Cipriani. So you're playing as Toni Cipriani. He's a capo in the Leone family in GTA 3. And this is actually his story on how he rose through the Leone mafia. And this is strictly a mafia game. This is a GTA game, but it has a very heavy mafia theme to it. And this game also has my favorite theme. Out of all the GTA games, this one has my favorite theme song for it. So let's play that intro right now. We gotta play that intro the very first time we're doing this. Oh man, nostalgia with this game. How I love this game. And if you guys enjoy this series, please do drop a like on it, because it does help the series out. I just love this theme. Unfortunately, he is no longer a rockstar. And also, this game is actually the next in line chronologically after San Andreas. So, basically the story here is that, several years ago, Tony was an associate of the Leone family. He was never a made man, and he had killed a made man, which a made man is a full member of the mafia for Salvatore. It's never, cleared up exactly what family it was from, either from the, Sindaco family or the Pirelli family, their rivals, and he had to go into exile. So he's been in exile for several years, and he's now returned to Liberty City and wants to continue working for the Leone family. And notice that theme that actually plays, that's actually GTA 3's theme, because again, remember, this is a prequel to GTA 3. This is, 6 years after San Andreas, so this is 1998 now.
So there he is, huh?
Hey.
So listen, Tony, I know you did a good thing for us, and I know you've been lying low for a long time. So I want you to take it easy for a while, huh? Vincenzo will look after you. You need some money? Ask him. You need a job? Lucky will take care of you. What more could a family guy ask for? Even my son don't got it so good.
But, Mr. Leone, I thought we got history. I mean, I've done a lot for this family. And now you're expecting me to take orders from this... Well, it just doesn't seem right.
Toni, I know what you did, and no one is more grateful than me, honestly. But the idea that you walk in here and start to question my leadership right away is, quite frankly, out of order. Capisce?
I understand, boss.
So when you need something, give Vincenzo a call down at Atlantic Key. He'll take care of you. Won't you, Lucky?
Of course, boss. Anything you say. Tell you what, we can go there now.
Now, this scene is actually set up pretty well. Notice how Salvatore actually looks at Toni right here in that scene. It's because Salvatore is extremely paranoid. That's probably why he doesn't give Toni that much respect right when he comes back, because he doesn't know what Tony's been up to those several years.
Got you a nice little place to stay, Toni. It's got you written all over it. We'll head there first.
I hate Vincenzo so much. Vincenzo is one of the most annoying GTA characters, definitely, and Rockstar designed him to be annoying. This is Toni's new home now.
This is it, Toni. Home sweet home. Beautiful, ain't she?
This shithole is supposed to be my home?
Oh, I think it's very you. Now you're disrespecting old Vincenzo. Now, tough guy, get your ass upstairs and go put on some decent clothes. I don't got all day, so move.
Okay, so we go up now. So this is Toni's apartment. This is his first safe house. He's gonna have 3 safe houses in the game. So there we go, we got the Leone outfit on. And it's nice how you can actually look out the window in this one, Remember in San Andreas in, I don't think there was a safe house in San Andreas where you could look out the window and see NPCs. And this is our garage. Get back in the car.
Now take me to my place.
Oh. Okay. So Vincenzo's gonna be the first guy that we're gonna be working for in the game.
Apartments cost money, Toni. Just you remember who pays the bills around here. Me, Daddy Vincenzo over here. So from now on, you work for me. So I better see you back here real soon.
I hate Vincenzo so much. Slacker, okay. Oh, this is the drug dealer mission, I think.
We got a dealer working on North Chinatown patch. The lazy bastard ain't brought any cash in days. Maybe he needs some encouragement to get off his ass and do some work. Acting like a bitch. He kind of reminds me of you.
Oh my God.
What are you trying to say?
I ain't trying to say nothing. I'm telling you to get over there and make sure this asshole starts bringing in some goddamn money.
Okay.
Hey, let's go to the phone.
Okay, so now we're gonna go pick up the drug dealer. And the thing is, you see how times have changed, because in Vice City, which is 12 years before this. The intro was actually in Liberty City, and the families wanted to stay away from drugs. And then when Sonny Forelli actually started getting involved in the drug trade, all the other families jumped on it.
So, Vincenzo tells me you're too chicken shit to work your patch.
Hey, man, I'm no chicken shit. I've been ill, is all. I'll go back to work tomorrow, or maybe the day after.
Oh, I think you're gonna work today, like it or not.
Oh, man, I don't feel too good. I think I might have a fever or something.
He's just making excuses. There's a reason for that.
Listen, man. I told you in your day. Tiny Tails don't go for the Leones now. This is Doc's moving in. If I go back there, I'm a dead man.
Sure.
I'm telling you, man. This is Doc's dealing.
So the Sindacos have moved into Leone family turf.
Careful!
Dealing revenge.
Vinny!
Crying out loud, Toni! Don't I get any peace? I'm already all blocked up. Last thing I need is you on my case. But it's just still here. You know, I'm still not seeing any money coming in from that dealer. You know why?
Enlighten me.
Because he's dead, idiot. Some chump whacked him. Sindacos have started dealing. And on Leone turf, too. You gonna accept that, Toni? I want you to get over to Chinatown.
All right, boss. I'm on it.
Oh, God, why is there never any goddamn paper in here?
Notice how disrespectful Vinny is in that he doesn't even, he won't even wait, he won't even come out of the bathroom when he's done to talk to Toni. He just talks to him, like, through the door, not showing him any respect whatsoever.
Stay off Leone Tarp, asshole!
Okay, and the thing is, though, a massive conflict has risen between the Sindacos and the Leones. Now, they've had conflict before this, but one of the main catalysts in this conflict was the casino. Remember the casino in San Andreas? Because Salvatore went into partnership with the Forellis and the Sindacos, but in reality he just ripped them off. And then what happened was CJ ripped Salvatore off, so all three families lost the casino, and the Sindacos probably blamed Leone's for it.
The Leone's dealing this city, nobody else. You hear me, you Sindaco crook?
Okay, so we got one more drug dealer to kill. The melee combat in this game is fairly simple. There we go. Okay, let's go do our next mission.
Liberty City commuters have been dealt a hard blow today when transport workers across the city took industrial action in sympathy for beleaguered ferry workers whose livelihoods are threatened by the construction of the new Porter Road Tunnel. Neither side in this battle seems keen to give any ground. Union Chief Jane Hopper said yesterday that she will bring the mayor to his knees before she's licked. More later on LCN.
So make sure to keep that in mind on the radio, that the unions are actually blocking the ferries. That's actually pretty important to the story later on.
Hey, remember J.D. O'Toole?
Difficult to forget.
Yeah, he's currently running a Sindaco-controlled titty bar. I mean, gentlemen's club. The interesting thing is, he wants to be a Leone now.
Fuck him, he made his choice.
Hello, brain cell? Geez, Toni, Sal said you was dumb muscle, but I didn't think anyone was that dumb. We can use J.D. to get the drop on Sindaco's plans. He's gonna be up on the inside. There's just one thing. He's being sat on by some Sindaco ape. I want you to remove this little obstacle and get JD on our side. Capiche?
Go to the local ammunition to get a gun, okay. Okay, let's get the pistol. Head for the construction site.
Hey, I nearly threw up my lunch!
Okay, there we go. First two Sindaco guards are dead. Okay, got him. Combat is very simple. Just lock on and shoot.
I can't wait till we're on the same team.
Don't get too excited. You still owe me money.
Take that Sindaco chump's car's deposit, huh? Just respray it so no one recognizes it. I'll take care of his body.
Liberty City commuters have been dealt a hard blow today when transport workers across the city took industrial action in sympathy for beleaguered ferry workers whose livelihoods are threatened by the construction of the new Porter Road Tunnel. Neither.
There we go. Let's do JD's first mission right now.
No work for no Leone. Hey, Toni, come back when you're less conspicuous.
All right, so we need to change outfits if we want to talk to JD. Okay, so now we're wearing our generic clothes, and we should be able to talk to JD.
Hey! JD, get out of here! Hey, JD, you little sicko, get the fuck out of here before I come in here and break your legs!
Oh, I'm coming! Oh, but not like that! Hey, Toni, que pasa, huh? Give us a hug!
Oh, you're sticky!
JD is such a creep.
See, the strip of stuff they put all over me, you know, they like it, you know. They put it anywhere. And, how you doing?
What the fuck are you wearing?
What? This? Oh, I'm an adventurous lover, you know. I like an experimental side, you know. Nothing wrong with that, huh? You can want you.
Oh, you're sick. You better shut the fuck up right now.
Okay, relax, Toni.
Where's my money?
See, that's the problem. We are getting ripped off. All right, now you wait here. I gotta go change out of this thing, you know. Hey, Raven, time to put away the double ender. Hey, Toni, let's you and me go for a drive. You know, we got some things we gotta check out. Hey, okay.
Oh, I'm sure the girls are ripping me off. We better draw the neighborhood and see what's up.
Okay, so...
That's one of my girls!
Hey, JD, I got your money right here.
Okay, so we just gotta drive around the red light
district.
That's
one of my girls in that car.
Hi, JD. I was just about to bring this to you. Honest.
Recognize that girl.
Look out, tough guy.
Did you think I wasn't gonna bring this to you or something?
I've got a date with the cheese deluxe.
Got myself a mission.
A lot of Sindacos around here too.
She's one of my girls.
Whoa, the NPCs is jumping in the way.
Are you checking up on us, girls, JD? It's so late. Why not come home?
That girl's one of ours.
Gee, don't you trust me no more, JD?
Pimp is ripping off one of my girls. Get them.
Okay, there we go. Well, what's with the NPCs here?
I bruise easily.
Okay, there's one more that we have to find still in this area. Man, I haven't done this in so long, I'm trying to remember exactly where.
Movement! I'm missing the sail!
Oh, right here. Okay.
Hey, JD, I got your money right here.
Nice work, Toni. I don't think the girls are gonna give me any more trouble on this shift.
Okay, so that will, I guess we'll wrap up the first part here. I hope that you guys are enjoying this, and I'll see you guys on the next one. Take care, everyone.